Welcome, class. Today, we'll dive into the technique of eavesdropping and its combination with cryptanalysis. Let's start by defining eavesdropping. Eavesdropping involves using network devices and techniques to intercept data during transmission. The process of eavesdropping consists of two steps. The first step is identifying the transmission path of the target network packets. Only by understanding this path can you install your software on the relevant routers or other network devices. This sets the stage for the actual eavesdropping. Spyware. The next step involves this network path, installing custom network devices, or deploying monitoring software, such as TCPdump or Wireshark. Let's examine the diagram on the right. We'll focus on the data path from host C to host B. Here, host C transmits data to host B. Following this route, along this path, we can see, to reach its destination, host C must pass through this router. This is the first router in the path. Then, it passes through a second router, finally reaching host B with the network packet. During this transmission, an attacker compromises the second router and installs eavesdropping software on it. As a result, all network packets from host C to host B are intercepted by the attacker. Now, let's explore cryptanalysis. Cryptanalysis, in essence, is decoding encrypted messages without the key. It aims to uncover the original message or extract valuable insights. Cryptanalysis is considered a science, yet it's also an art form. Why call it an art? Because it relies on experience-based intuition. This means that for different analysts, results can vary significantly. Skilled cryptanalysts can extract incredibly valuable information. For a novice, decrypting ciphertext can be quite challenging. Let's look at an example. The substitution cipher. You probably know that in English, the letter E is the most common. T is the second most frequent. In the substitution cipher, the encrypted text, most common letter, likely represents E. In the original plain text, the letter E, while the second most frequent letter likely corresponds to the letter T in the original text. To defend against cryptanalysis, we need to use longer encryption keys and more secure encryption algorithms. This section covered eavesdropping and cryptanalysis tools. That concludes this topic.